Hello and welcome back to High Functioning Gaming. Grab a few of these things here. Actually, might as well check out the rest of the cave. Okay, so there's a whole lot more to this, the cave. Huh. Rather not climb all the way back up there. That seems like I have to. At least a good chunk of the way. Expect nothing less from me. Well, I've told you that you need to know what you need to know about the sensor, but I fear it's gone in one ear and out the other, so hang on a minute. Travel medallion, hero's path mode, sensor plus. Sensor plus. Hey! I think I'm good for now. Oh, man, so many shrines, so little time. It's probably rather chilly over there. That means that by extension, I am going to need... Oh wait, she just headed and went straight to Goron City. Marbled rock roast is sold out here. This is the last one. What is Yunobu Ko doing then? They better get on and dig up more pronto. Digging up marbled rock roast is your job. Come on, cut this out. Once I finish this marbled rock roast, I'm heading to Goron City to buy more. Tool, go get the rupees together. Big bro, you always wanted to be part of Yunobu Ko. And you always, and you finally got in, but now you're just sitting here munching. Read on.
When the glow of the blood-stained moon shines upon the land, the endless spirits of slain monsters return to flesh. The world is threatened once again.
Trying to get into this cave? I'm not stopping folks, but I'll tell you, it's boiling inside the cave. You'll be burned to a crisp going in there like that. In that case... You know that's contained with gloom, right? And how else do you explain the color? Just one green rupee? That's it? I don't know, it was pretty cheap in the last game. Definitely cheaper than this. Not sure how I managed to end up with so much topaz, but I'm not complaining. Hey, that'll do it. What? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. I'm just six short? Exploring around Death Mountain, because I'm gonna have to upgrade that, and I'm gonna have to upgrade that armor, and that's gonna take a lot of rupees. So I'm really gonna explore it. is that strong. This would provide some light in a dark place, like the depths, wouldn't it? I'll have to keep it around to experiment with. Okay, I know there's some really good ore deposits in this place, and they're supposed to respawn after every blood moon. So where's my freaking gems? Oh, come on. Like that? Crap. You gotta be kidding me. So the gems didn't respawn. Wonderful. Oy. That does mean the zonite deposits respawned, along with the abandoned mines restocking. So that's good. I guess. weird place for a well, I guess. Oh yeah, forgot about that. Very good, parents! Why are hardy truffles always in caves this time around? That's right, I thought. Ooh, nice. Oh, come on! I'm gonna need more than that. Doink! Doink! That way. So the stakes give me an idea. Whole lot of materials there. I know what the deal is. Grumph! Well, at least there's a rich deposit right there. Oh, come on! Thank you. beetle. There he is. Seems like the best way to make money in this game, much like the last, is selling monster parts. Well, one of the best ways, anyway. Speed of which. I guess I shouldn't have sold all those guts. Or Moblin Horns! Would've been nice to know that sooner. So where can I find regular moblins? Yeah. Hyrule Field and Central Hyrule Depths. Well, I do need to get more zonite, so that works out. Hey, Riju, where'd you go? I just wouldn't have gotten zonite out of those before. Out of wooden crates in the depths. And there's the buzzer. So as always, folks, do not stop being awesome and I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, take care.